pretend the tale of Sweeney Todd. His skin was pale and his eye was odd.
He shaved the faces of gentlemen who never thereafter were heard of again.
He trod a path that few have trod.
Did Sweeney Todd, the demon barber of Fleet Street.
He kept a shop in London town, of fancy clients and good renown.
And what if none of their souls were saved? They went to their maker impeccably shaved.
By Sweeney Todd, the demon barber of Fleet Street.
Is it for wages singing to be sung? I feel you, Johanna. I feel you. I was half convinced I'd waken, satisfied enough to dream you. Happily I was mistaken, Johanna. I'll steal you, Johanna. I'll steal you. Do they think that walls can hide you? Even now I'm at your window. I am in the dark beside you, buried sweetly in your yellow hair. I'm with you then, I'm with you there, sweetly buried in your yellow hair.
A customer! Watch your rush, watch your hurry. You gave me such a fright, I thought you was a ghost. Half a minute, can't you sit, sit you down, sit. All I meant is that I haven't seen a customer for weeks. Did you come in for a pie, sir? Do forgive me if me head's a little fake. Ugh, what is that? But you think we had the plague? From the way that people keep affording, no you don't. Heaven knows I try, sir. Ugh, but there's no one comes in even to inhale. Right you are, sir, would you like a drop of ale? Mind you, I can't hardly blame them. These are probably the worst pies in London. I know why nobody cares to take them. I should know, I make them, but good now, the worst pies in London. Even that's polite, the worst pies in London. If you doubt it, take a bite. Is that just disgusting? You have to concede it. It's nothing but grasping. You drink this, you'll need it. The worst pies in London. And no wonder with the price of meat what it is. When you get it, never thought I'd live to see the day. Men are thinking what's a treat. Funny poor animals, what are dying in the street. Mrs. Mooney has a pie shop, does a business, but I've noticed something weird. Lately all the neighbours' cats have disappeared. Have to hand it to her, what I call enterprise. Popping pussies into pies wouldn't do in my shop. Just the thought of it's enough to make you sick. And I'm telling you, them pussycats is quick. Now denying times is hard, sir. Even harder than the worst pies in London. Only lard and nothing more is than just revolting. All greasy and gritty. It looks like it's melting and tasty. Well, pity a woman alone with limited wind and the worst pies in London. Ah, sir, times is hard, times is hard.
And what may I do for you, sir? A stylish trimming of the hair, a soothing skin massage.
You see, sir, a man infatuate with love, her ardent and eager slave. So fetch the pomade and pomace stone and lend me a more seductive tone, a sprinkling perhaps of French cologne. But first, sir, I think a shave.
The closest I ever gave.
Yeah,
merry mood today, Mr. Todd.
'Tis your delights are catching fire from one man to the next.
'Tis true, sir, love can still inspire the blood to pound the heartly pyre. What more can man require than love, sir?
More than love, sir.
What, sir?
Women.
Ah, yes, women.
Pretty women.
And if we wed, you'll be commended, sir.
My lord. And who may it be said is your intended, sir?
My ward.
And pretty as a rosebud.
Pretty as her mother.
What? What was that?
Oh, nothing, sir. Nothing. Nothing. May we proceed?
Pretty women. Fascinating, sipping coffee, dancing, pretty women are a wonder, pretty women, sitting in the
how they make a man sing. Proof of heaven, as you're living, pretty women, sir, pretty women.
Yes,
pretty women,
pretty women,
pretty women,
sir.
She says she'll marry me Sunday, everything's set, really.
You, Judge Turpin!
There is indeed a higher power to warn me thus in time. Johanna, elope with you? I'll lock her up in some obscure retreat where neither you nor any other vile, corrupting youth shall ever lay eyes on her again.
But, sir, I beg of you.
And as for you, Barbara, it is all too clear what company you keep. Service them well and hold their custom, for you'll have none of mine.
Mr. Todd.
You know me. Bright ideas just pop into me head and I keep thinking. Seems a downright shame.
Shame.
Seems an awful waste. Such a nice plump frame. What's his name? Has. Nor it can't be traced. Business needs a lift. That's to be erased. Think of it as a thrift, as a gift, if you get my drift. Now, seems an awful waste. I mean, with the price on meat, what it is, when you get it, if you get it. Good, you got it. Take a visit, Mrs. Mooney, and a pie. never better, using only pussy cats and toast. Now a pussy's good for maybe 6 or 7 at the most. And I'm sure they can't compare as far as taste.
Mrs. Lovett, what a charming notion.
Well,
eminently practical and yet appropriate as always. Mrs. Lovett, how I've lived without you all these years, I'll never know.
Think
how
about it. Love of other gentlemen will soon be coming for a shame.
Won't
they think of
choice,
all their life?
What's the sound of the world out there?
What is that sound?
Those crunching noises pervading the air.
Yes, Mr. Todd, yes, Mr. Todd, yes, Lord, around.
It's man devouring man, my dear. And who are we to deny it in here? Ah, these are desperate times, Mrs. Lovett, and desperate measures are called for.
Here we are, hot from the oven.
What is that?
It's priest. Have a little priest.
Is it really good?
Sir, it's too good, at least. Then again, they don't call it sins of the flesh, so it's pretty fresh.
Awful lot of fat.
Only where it's sat.
Haven't you got poet or something like that?
No, you see, the trouble with poet is how do you know it's deceased? Try the priest.
Heavenly! Well, not as hearty as bishop, perhaps, but they're not as bland as curate either.
And good for business. Always leaves you wanting more. Trouble is, we only get it in Sundays. Lawyers ravenous.
If it's for a price.
Order something else thou to follow, since now one should swallow it twice.
Anything that's lean.
Well, then, if you're British and loyal, you might enjoy Royal Marine. Anyway, it's clean. Though, of course, it tastes of wherever it's been.
Is that squire on the fire?
Mercy, no, sir, look closer. You'll notice it's grosser.
Thicker, more like vicar.
No, it has to be grosser. It's green.
History of the world, my love.
Save a lot of graves, do a lot of relatives favor.
Is those below serving those up above?
Everybody shaves, so there should be plenty of flavor.
How gratifying for once to know
that those above will serve those down below. Now let's see. We've got Tinker.
No, no, something pinker.
Taylor.
Something paler.
Potter?
Something hotter.
Butler?
Something subtler.
Locksmith? Lovely bit of clock.
Maybe for a lark.
Then again, the sweep, if you want it cheap and you like it dark. Try the financier, peak of his career.
That looks pretty rank.
Well, he drank. No, it's bank cashier. Never really sold. Maybe it was old.
Have you any beetle?
Next week, so I'm told. Beetle isn't bad till you smell it and notice how well it's been greased. Stick to grease. Stringy, but then of course it's fiddle player.
No, no, this isn't fiddle player. It's piccolo player.
How can you tell?
It's piping hot.
Then blow on it first.
The history of the world, my sweet.
Oh, Mr. Todd, oh, Mr. Todd, what does it tell?
Is who gets eaten and who gets to eat.
And Mr. Todd, too, Mr. Todd, who gets to sell.
But fortunately, it's also clear that everybody goes down well with beer.
Since Marine doesn't appeal to you, how about Rear Admiral?
No, no, it's too salty. I prefer General.
With or without his privates? With his extra.
Ha, 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 ha,
is that?
It's fop, finest in the shop. Or we have some shepherd's pie peppered with actual shepherd on top. And I've just begun. Is the politician so oily? It's served with a doily, not one.
Put it on a bun. Well, you never know if it's going to run.
Ride it higher.
No, the clergy is really too coarse and too mealy.
That actor, that's compactor.
Yes, and always arrives overdone. I'll come again when you have Judge on the menu.
Wait, true, we don't have Judge yet. But we've got something you might fancy even better.
What is that?
Executioner!
Have charity towards the world, my pet.
Yes, yes, I know, my love.
We'll take the customers that we can get.
Highborn and low, my love.
We'll not discriminate great from small. No, we'll serve anyone, meaning anyone, and to anyone at all.
I'm so happy I could eat you up, I really could. You know what I'd like to do, Mr. Todd. What I dream, if the business stays as good, where I really like to go in a year or so. Don't you want to know?
Of course.
Do you really want to know?
Yes, yes, I do, I do.
By the sea, Mr. Todd, that's the life I have it. By the sea, Mr. Todd, ooh, I know you'd love it. You and me, Mr. T, we could be alone in a house what we'd almost own down by the sea.
Anything you say.
Wouldn't that be smashing? With the sea at our gate, we'll have kip and herring. What the swan to is straight from the strengths of bearing. Every night in the kip, when we're through our kip, I'll be there slipping off your slippers by the sea with the fishy splashing by the sea. Wouldn't that be smashing down by the sea?
Anything you say, anything you say.
I can see us waking, the breakers breaking, the seagulls squawking. With you, you, I want me bones of the Esplanade, a tea and scones with me gay young blade. Then I'll knit a sweater while you write a letter, unless we got better to do.
Anything you say.
Think how snug it'll be underneath our flannel when it's just you and me and the English Channel in our cozy retreat, kept all neat and tidy. We'll have chums over every Friday by the sea.
Anything you say.
Don't you love the weather by the sea? We'll grow old together by the sea. Stop by the beautiful sea. Oh, I can see us now in our bathing dresses. You in a nice navy and me stripes, perhaps. It'll be so quiet that who'll come by it except the seagull. Ooh, ooh, we shouldn't try it though till it's legal for two. But a seaside wedding could be devised. Me rumpled bedding legitimized. Me eye little platter, I'll turn into butter the moment I mutter I do. By the sea in our nest, we could share our kippers with the odd paying guest from the weekend trippers. Have a nice sunny suite for the guests to rest in now and then. You could do that guesting by the sea.